And they just dump smoke.
All right. Brew day at B&H's house. We got Immo chilling.
Check that out.
Got hops in the back. And we got an air show in town. Here they come. That's what we call a good brew day. Check that out. All right. Cheers.
It's a good IPA.
All right, so there's the gruit. How would you describe that?
It doesn't taste like beer. Just like you said, it's not like wine. It doesn't taste like alcohol.
Yeah, it's like 6%.
That tastes like a floral iced tea, refreshing drink.
It's a summertime. I think it's sort of a summery, almost like an alcoholic Arnold Palmer almost. It's got really good carbonation and it's got a real nice aftertaste.
Yes, that is very good. Very good. Arrogant, you need to brew this now.
Yeah, we're Arrogant, we're sending you some Gruit ingredients, so.
Mugwort and the little bit of chamomile, Yarrow mugwort, and Germania, and heather. So that's what's going in for the...
And there's already hops in there.
Yeah, I put a little bit of hops in here just because I wanted it to have a little bit more of a bitter kick on the front end. But yeah, that's the main ingredients there.
All right.
It's essentially the same thing that I did last time. I have an extra ingredient, and I backed off from the chamomile because the chamomile was a little bit too. I don't know. It was a little too much on the chamomile. I mean, it wasn't bad though. I mean, you liked it, right?
It was good.
Just thought that it'd be best to back off from the chamomile just a little bit. So, I'll boil all these guys for 30 minutes tops. So the heather and the yarrow and mugwort and all that. Yeah, I really hope people try it because I think it's worthy of trying.
How long are we into the boil?
I boiled it for 60, but I started adding the gruit ingredients at 40. The second batch went in at 20 minutes, and then about 5 minutes from now we'll put the 10 minute from the end of the boil additions in.
Holy cow.
That's totally different. Hibiscus. Can you see that? Here, let's go inside. Chamomile, hibiscus, yarrow, mugwort, demania.
Yeah, you...
Heather.
People definitely need to brew this.
This is
completely different.
It's really
completely
smooth.
Different. Very, very smooth. From when we
super red. That's got to be the hibiscus. Is that red, purpley kind of color?
From when you added the hops the first time to what we just tried it just now, completely different. Very, very smooth. Oh yeah, that's tasty.
Yeah, that's about right.
Are those going in now?
The twigs are pretty weird, though, huh?
Yeah, that's
Now I got 4 minutes. I'm just getting impatient.
That stuff is good.
What do you think? Red, purple?
Maybe? Yeah. Especially in the light like this, you can tell it.
Well, you can kind of see the purple hues here a little bit. I mean, this is, you know, because it's been soaking. And there's that sort of, it's like a really red, orangish kind of, I don't know. I like the color.
And this taste.
This
fantastic.
Is the same color as it was.
All right, we're going to pull a gravity on Immo's Gruit. And it's an awesome red color. Very, very clear right now even. Let's give her a spin here.
That's a little higher gravity than I thought. 1.082 maybe?
That's a 1082 right there.
It's kind of like a cross. It's not really a mead. It's not really a beer. It's not really like a dessert wine. And it's not entirely unlike an iced tea or a soda pop. It's kind of somewhere in the middle of all of those. The one that we had, I don't know, did we shoot video on that?
We did.
Okay, so we did. The one that we poured here earlier, I'm assuming in this video.
Yep.
Or maybe you'll highlight it right here or something. It has like the big fat soda pop bubbles, and it doesn't have any aftertaste. You can't tell that there's alcohol in it. We gave it to his neighbor, and the neighbor's comment was, well, I know that there's alcohol in it, but I can't tell that there is, you know? So that was a really nice compliment as the person who brewed that beer. That was really cool to hear somebody say, hey, this is fantastic. I can't tell that there's any alcohol at all. It's real smooth. It's sort of its own flavor. I mean, I've never really had anything like it. And having brewed the first batch, I really wanted to do the second batch. Changed up a few things. I stretched the chamomile out over the boil. Instead of just doing it at 20 and 10 minutes, I put a quarter ounce at 40 minutes, and then I split the last quarter ounce between the 20 minute and 10 minute additions. In the batch that I did today, simply because I wanted to have some more bittering in the front end, a little bit more of a bitter bite, I first wort hopped with an ounce of Sterling, which is like a low alpha hop, just to give a hint of more of a bitter on the front end. And everything else was the Gruit herbs. I added some new ingredient based on the recommendations from the lady at the Herbs and Art Store. And we'll see how this one turned out. I was expecting 1.07. I yielded just under 5 gallons, and it ended up at 1.082, so that was kind of a surprise. This particular batch is extract only. We used 8 pounds of amber and 4 pounds of light malt extract. It turned out really, really good. Tastes very similar to what we brewed, to what we tasted today. So I'm attributing that sort of character, that attitude, to all the Gruit herbs that we added in. So I'm definitely going to be doing this again. It's quickly becoming something that I think I want to have as my staple. Everybody that I've given it to has been like, oh yeah, this stuff is great. So it didn't last very long at my house. It's really easy to drink. It's deceptive. It's got sort of an otherworldly buzz to it. Something just can't put your finger on it. It's just a little bit off the beaten path, and I think that's what I like about it. I mean, I've been brewing since 94, and I've had every different kind of beer that I've brewed, and this is like a breath of fresh air almost. So it's something I'd like to have other people try, just to give me feedback, because I'd really like to perfect the recipe. But for having never done it, you know, first time was, you know, I think I got it pretty much to where I want it, having never tried it.
It's good.
So
it's good. The thing that I noticed about it too when we were talking is it doesn't give you a buzz like normal beer or wine or any other alcohol thing. It's got kind of a, you're just mellow and you're like ready to, I could just fall asleep now type buzz to it, which is and it, like you said, it comes on and it doesn't last. It's not very harsh. It's not a hard buzz. It's very, very smooth, and you could drink this all afternoon, and that's what could be deadly about it.
Oh yeah, I mean, you could easily chop your lawn up if you're running a lawnmower better than you had expected. Because I had the keg for like 2 weeks, and then it was just gone. You know, and I kept going and pouring another. You know, when I had it on tap, I split off a couple bottles, which is the one that you drank, and then everything else went into the keg, and the keg was gone in no time. I mean, I blinked my eyes and it was gone. And you know, it's not like I was drinking it every single day, all day long. It was just 2 weeks. I'd come home after work, I'd pour a couple of those things, and the next thing I knew, it was out.
And drinking it on ice, just like you said, like a soda, it was.
Yeah, I tried it. I tried it warm. I tried it cold. I tried it on ice. I basically tried it on ice simply because it had the big fat bubbles. I was like, this is kind of like a soda pop. I should put this on ice. And it's fantastic on ice. So definitely a weird, it's something, you know, it's something different. You know, I liked it. It's very sweet, has a lot of residual sweetness to it, a lot of floral characteristics too. When I transferred the original batch from primary to secondary, I actually thought that I had like a stuck fermentation, because of course when you go from primary to secondary you're going to taste it. And I tasted it and I was like, oh god, it's too sweet, I got a stuck fermentation, I'm going to have to start this over. So I went and I grabbed my hydrometer, which is, you know, I rarely grab my hydrometer, and I dumped it in there and it was like, finished out at like 1.01 or 1.012 or, you know, somewhere in the finishing range. But I had no idea that it was finished. I actually thought that, you know, just by tasting it, that it was like 1.04, like tasted like it was half finished. And I actually had to use the hydrometer just to make sure that, oh yeah, it fermented all the way out, but it didn't taste like it fermented all the way out. So the alcohol was really well hidden. And that's pretty much the common feedback that I've had is, I have no idea that there was alcohol in this. That's really good. So
it's good.
The buzz definitely creeps up on you because you don't know what's coming.
It's good. So yeah, hopefully a lot of people will start to brew it. And the actual recipe is on one of your videos.
The original recipe is this. This I'll have to do another video and highlight it. And maybe put what I did differently in this one. But the original recipe is on the original, you know, my first attempt at Gruit video. So, you know, check it out if you guys want to give it a try. But if you do, please leave comments in the video. So I kind of know how things turned out. Like Warrior and Hen tried to do a Gruit. I think he used Wormwood, which is really, really bitter. I think he was going to use the Wormwood for the bittering edition. And his feedback on his, when we talked, was that it didn't turn out the way that he liked, or it was too bitter, or something was off on it, and he didn't like it. And then Horned Helmet did one that on Craig's broadcast, he had, you know, we'd talked in the chat room, and he might have even called in, and he said that he gave it to his brew club and took the keg in, and the keg just vanished, and that everybody loved it. So of the two folks that have tried it, I think Horned Helmet did something that was very similar to the recipe that I did in my original video. I don't know if Warrior and Hen did that or not. I know he used some different ingredients, you know, what was available in his area. Check out his channel. He's got this how to make kombucha video that I'm assuming, I've never done kombucha, but this is very iced tea-like. I'm wondering if this might actually be good with the kombucha SCOBY. You know, sort of the best of both worlds. So if I can ever find or get my hands on a kombucha SCOBY, I want to split some of this stuff off and maybe try fermenting it with the SCOBY. That'd be